Hello, I'm Carly McVoy, and today I'm talking about finding intercepts when the equation is in standard form. So the x and y intercepts, find the x and y intercepts for the following equation and label your answers correctly. Okay, that's important because sometimes you will find those two things and they don't really know what they found or how to label them, so we'll talk about that. So what I'm talking about in this video are equations in standard form. And standard form means that the x and the y are together on the same side of the equation. In the next video, we'll look at ones that are in a different format. So what I know about x and y intercepts is that if I have x and y intercepts, then those points involve a zero. Anytime I'm looking at something and I want to know the x and y intercepts, I know that those two points only exist if there's a zero in the ordered pair. And that I explained in the previous video. So if I ask you to find the x-intercept and the y-intercept, what I'm asking you to find is to find the two points that have zeros in them. That is, I want you to find these two points because those are the two points that would be intercepts. Okay, it doesn't matter which one you find first, but which one would this be? Would this be the x-intercept or the y-intercept? Well, y is zero, so if I go left and right, that's fine, but I can't go up or down. So if I can't go up or down, that means I'm going to be stuck on the x-axis. So this is A, or x-intercept. Remember, you can abbreviate x-intercept with A, but you can't use x. That means something different. So we can't use x, but if we don't want to write out x-intercept, you can write A. What's this one? Well, in this one, we're saying we're starting at the origin. We can't go left or right, but we can go up and down. So we're going to be on the y-axis here. So this is our y-intercept. So this would be a perfectly acceptable way to write your final answer. The label would be the A and the B that you got correct. So we want to know, well, what if Y was 0? What would X be? So we just go in and we plug in the value we know and we solve for the other value. Dividing both sides by negative 3, I get X is negative 2. So that would be my x-intercept. All right, and then I want to find out my y-intercept. So I'm going to say x is 0. And then next, negative 3 times 0 drops away because it's 0, and y equals 6. So there's my answer. I have an x-intercept of negative 2 and a y-intercept of 6. And I didn't ask you to do this, but let's say that I ask you to graph that equation. Well, I could graph that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 6. No, that's 5. Yikes. Okay, anyway, you could graph it if you knew what you were doing, because this is 6 on the y-axis and negative 2 on the x-axis, and then you could have a point there. So you can graph just knowing those two points. And this is breaking my own rules about didn't use a ruler. Look how sloppy I am. It's awful. So that's good excuse, good example of bad practice. Okay, what about finding the x and y intercepts here? One way I can label this is to actually say x-intercept and y-intercept. So this is another way to do that. If I want to find the x-intercept, I need to make the y 0. And if I want to find the y-intercept, I make the x 0. Okay. Now, if the y is 0 here, I'm going to get negative x minus 2 times 0 is negative 4. And then divide both sides by negative 1 and x equals 4. So my x-intercept would be 4. And now my y-intercept, if x is 0, negative times 0 minus 2y equals negative 4. Obviously, that just drops out. Negative 2y is negative 4. And dividing both sides by 2, negative 2, I get y equals 2. And so I have my two intercepts. Notice I wrote them this way here, and I wrote them x-intercept and y-intercept here. It's the same idea. But I could also just do this, a equals 4 and b equals 2. That also says my x-intercept is 4, my y-intercept is 2. So you can write them as an ordered pair, but you could also write them in this way. It says the same thing, as long as you're using a and b and not x and y. Okay, I think I left actual room for graphing on these second two, so we'll look at the graph, what we might be able to get from this. I wanted to do something like 3 and 4 because I wanted you to experience fractions. It doesn't always come out to be a nice number. I'm going to say my A and my B. I like A and B because I'm lazy about writing that out. But I like the ordered pairs because it helps me kind of see things better. In order to get an x-intercept, I need a y of 0. In order to get a y-intercept, I need an x of 0. So those are the two points that I'm going to solve. What if y was 0? Well, I'd have 2x plus 5 times 0 equals 4. Or 2x equals 4, or x equals 2. That one came out nicely. But my other one, if I have x be 0, then I have 2 times 0 plus 5y equals 4. And if I divide both sides by 5, I get y equals 4/5. Well, I don't like that one so much, because I have a fraction, but that the reality is that you are going to have fractions. You cannot avoid them, so get used to them. I could, from my two intercepts, graph these things if I wanted. Okay, so I kind of got ahead of myself earlier trying to show you that, and I did a terrible job. So let's look at it. If the x-intercept is 2, that would go right here. On the x-axis is 2. The y-intercept is 4/5. Well, I don't know. 4/5 is less than 1, so it's right in here, right? And those two points are enough for me to graph my equation if I wanted to, right? So finding the intercepts can help us graph the equation. A third point would be a nice check, though, right? And now I'm over here. I'm just going to do, again, A and B. So I do the labeling right off, so I'm not going to get that messed up. I know for x-intercept I make y, and for the y-intercept I make x 0. What if my y was 0? I'd have negative 3x plus 4 times 0 is negative 8. Negative 3x is negative 8, and dividing both sides by negative 3, I get x equals 8/3. Again, a fraction, but I'm not afraid of it. And then what if I'm stumbling over my words. What if x is 0? Negative 3 times 0 plus 4y is negative 8. This term drops out to 0. 4y is negative 8, and dividing both sides by 4, I get y equals negative 2. Okay. Now I'm going to graph those two points just to show you that finding the intercepts, there is a reason. And y-intercept is especially important, and that's always our starting point when we talk about scenarios and making them real. That's always the starting point, so it's really important. So we have an A is 8/3, and that's not quite 3, right? 9 over 3 would be 3. A is our x-intercept, so we're like not quite to 3. I'm going to call it right here. And then B is negative 2. That's our y-intercept. And from those two points, I can graph the equation then. All right, that's finding the intercepts when your equation is in standard form.